Welcome to another demonstration of What's New in NXCAM. This video will show you how you can now create tube machining operations to finish complex interior surfaces typically found in manifolds and cylinder head ports. We'll begin by machining the small port. Click Create Operation. Select Mill Multi-Axis from the type list. Select Tube Finishing. This option is new. Specify the following. Tube finishing operations may use ball mill or spherical mill tools. Click OK. Click Display next to specify cut area. The end of the central curve you select determines the start point of the tool path. Click Specify Central Curve. Select the upper end of the central curve in the small port. Click OK. Because of its complex shape and depth, the port must be finished by machining half of it from one end and the other half from the other end. In the Drive Method section of the dialog box, click Tube Finish. The machining region and drive setting parameters are set by default to the most frequently used options. When Sides is set to both, the toolpath cuts to the specified range depth from each end of the port. When set to Entry or Exit, the toolpath will cut from one end or the other. Type 2 in the maximum distance list. Click OK. Click Cutting Parameters. Select the Containment tab. Specify the following clearance values. Click OK. Click Generate. Click Verify. Click Play. Click OK to complete the toolpath visualization. Click OK to complete the operation. You may specify cut area surfaces that do not belong to part geometry. This is useful when you wish to extend toolpaths beyond the port. Here, you see extension surfaces for the large port. This concludes the demonstration of how you could now create tube machining operations to finish complex interior surfaces. Thank you.